Hi, Bill Caskey back at Whiteboard Wednesday. Welcome back. One thing I want to tell you before I tell you about our episode that I think has some really cool things in it, I want to remind you, and we have told you about this a couple months ago, but go to samegamenewrules.com. You can download the free version of Same Game New Rules, the ebook version. Also, there are three or four videos that you get when you download that, when you give us your name and email address. So make sure you get that. I think you're going to find some of the videos interesting, even if you've read the book. That's fine. Go ahead and get the book. At least you'll get the videos that way. Go to samegamenewrules.com. In today's episode of Whiteboard Wednesday, we've got three things that we're going to talk about. Number one, we're going to go back in time and look at a podcast interview that we did recently, Brian Neal and I, where we interviewed Kevin Eikenberry. And you may have heard of Kevin. He's written several books. His most recent book is called From Bud to Boss. And it talks about the plight a little bit of how when you're a salesperson and maybe you're on a team and all of a sudden you become the manager, how do you treat everybody? What are some tips, some techniques, some strategies? And it can go both ways, whether you're the person who didn't get promoted or you're the person that did. It's really an interesting interview. Kevin Eikenberry, so you'll see that. Second thing is Brooke Green comes back. And she talks a little bit about the new reality. You know, we've talked about this in past episodes and podcasts and TV shows about did the recession and the slowdown really change the reality? We think it did. Now, we think things are picking up. We think the trend is really good. But we believe that it really fundamentally changed the whole buyer path inside of large companies. So she's going to talk about that a little bit. Then we're going to go back into time also and pick up a clip of an advanced selling podcast live event that we did here a few months ago. We had a question from the audience about how do I get access to the decision maker? And we took a look at that and pulled it out, and I think you'll find some of our answers interesting there. So I hope you enjoy Whiteboard Wednesday for this week. Final question here, Kevin, is a lot of our listeners are salespeople and contributors and performers, right, and producers. The question is, we have a lot of people, I'm sure. Some people don't want to manage people. Others, sure, do. And so they believe they have a gift, and they probably do. What advice would you give to someone who maybe is on a team, maybe their manager is getting up there in years or is ready to leave, mm-hmm, to position themselves so that they're ready? What are a couple of ideas, mm-hmm, for that?
Well, I think you want to start thinking about that perspective. So I think the thing is, read differently. And obviously I'd like them to read my book, mm-hmm, but that's not really what I'm saying. What I'm really saying is, if all you're reading is the industry publications, then you're not thinking, yeah, about the right stuff. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You've got to read and prepare yourself for a new perspective, which is start thinking like a leader. Start
great
reading.
Great advice.
This is just a very general. I mean, don't just read your industry publication. Read Forbes and Fortune and Fast Company, and mm-hmm, those are just simple examples, right? Mm-hmm. Listen to some other podcasts besides
on leadership.
This on, yeah, leadership, right, yeah, on management, on those things. So I think it's about preparing yourself for a new perspective, which is building your skills, being conscious about what you're reading, what you're intaking, who you're spending time with, and getting the chance to be with those people that can help you start to think and build the skills in, yeah, those areas. That would be my
great
short
advice,
piece of advice.
Great advice. So it's skills, good, relationships, and
perspectives.
Perspectives. Very, very good. Yeah. You can find, again, information and buy the book at
FromBudToBoss.com.
FromBudToBoss.com.
Or any of, you know, any online, wherever you want to go.
Kevin
Eikenberry. Copies of books.
And Kevin's very active on Twitter and LinkedIn,
yes,
as we are, and encourage our clients to be. So he can't hide. I'm sorry.
You know, you can't.
Yeah, he went to Jordan to try to hide.
He did.
it didn't work there either.
Because people were Twittering in Jordan.
But highly recommend everyone, yeah, take a look at the book. Get the book. Follow Kevin Eikenberry. He's got great information. Very, very useful.
Good. Kevin, thanks for coming in today.
It's my pleasure. Thanks, guys.
Appreciate you taking time out of your schedule.
See you next time.
All right. See you next time. Bye.
A couple of years ago, there was a lot of conversation about the recession and how we were going to work in the recession. I think it's interesting because there's still a couple people that think, have their heads buried in the sand and think we're going to go back to the way we were. I'd like to call this our new reality. I don't think the world will ever be the way it was. I think this is our new reality, and we really need to learn how to operate best in it. So I was thinking about that. How can we not let this new reality go to waste? Because it's really a great time to sort of sharpen all the tools that you have and get things in line. So there's four areas that I wanted to talk about today where I really think this new reality, we could take a lot of advantage of it. So the first place is your workforce. So if you are a manager or a CEO or the owner of a company, this is such a great time to right-size your underperformers. Your employees or the people that work for you are your most expensive assets, so you need to be getting the most return on the investment for those folks. You know, it's sort of like the cream rises to the top and so do other things. I'm sure you've all heard the expression, turds in a punch bowl. Sorry for the nasty imagery, but it's true. So when things aren't easy to do, the crap kind of rises to the top and it's easy to see. And it might be people that you've known for a long time really need to go. Now is a great time to do it. So the first place to take advantage of this new reality is in your workforce, okay? The second place is in training. You knew I had to get that in there since that's what our company does, right? So now you have this group of all of your top, maybe mid and top performers. Now's the time to really give them an edge, to invest in them, to develop them. And it doesn't even have to be outside training. Maybe it's cross-training within your organization to less silo communication and information. Or maybe it is to put your people in front of your prospects and clients in a new way, really making a real machine out of your company. I'm not sure who said it, but I love the phrase, if you're not green and growing, you're ripe and rotting. And training and development and things are a way to keep your people green and growing. And oh, by the way, it's a great way to hang on to your really good people, because most companies out there are offering some sort of personal development for their employees. So it's just really, really important. Good time to do it. Third area, coming up with some new ideas. When is the last time that you really did something different? Started a blog, did a podcast, had a customer event where everybody came together, maybe did a lunch and learn or something. This is a great time to try some new ideas, to differentiate yourself from your competition. You've got to be thinking outside the box. People are afraid to buy things. They're afraid to change. Do not be the company that stays under the radar, that stays status quo, because you're going to be left behind. This is a time to try some new things. Survey your customers. Ask them what they would like from you. You know, is it, are you asking them questions? Are you doing things that bring value to their organization? If you're not, you've got to figure it out. Figure out some things to do. Let your people talk to you about some new ideas, some new ways to go to market. Make sense? The fourth area is with your clients. And I know we're all guilty of this. You've had a client for 100 years. You've got a great relationship. We almost take them for granted. We don't give them the value of some of the things we do with prospects or new clients. Easy things that we should be doing all the time anyway. Asking them the tough questions. Talking to them about their dreams, their goals, their visions. What's working? What's not working? How are we doing? Have you really asked them for an honest response to how you're doing? Have you continued to meet new people within their organization? Or are you just going to lunch every month and talking about your kids because that's what you do? I'm telling you right now, that's not going to cut it anymore. Dropping donuts every Friday morning, while it's a really nice thing to do, it does not continue to add value to your clients. So really dig in with your clients. Ask them the tough questions. You might even have to preface it by saying, you know what, Sue? We've been client and partner for so long that I can't remember the last time we've had a really good business conversation. It almost feels weird having it, but I think it's about time we did that again. So let yourself off the hook. Say it out loud, put it on the table, but you've got to start engaging in those deeper conversations. That's the new reality. So the four areas, your workforce, get the right people on the bus in the right seats, training, invest in your people, get the best return on investment. It's another way to differentiate your company. New ideas. Now is the time to get creative, to be thinking outside the box, to try some new things. If they don't work, whatever, move on to the next thing, but you've got to be thinking bigger, better. And lastly, and probably most important, do not take your clients for granted. The ones that you have, you want to keep. They're also the people that can put you in front of new potential clients. But if you're not doing your best for them, if you're not continuing to bring value, they're not going to be open to doing that. So that's it for the new reality. I hope you'll take some lessons from this and try some new things out. Thanks.
First question, can we have some tips on how to gain access to the decision makers of an organization? Tips on how to gain access to the decision makers of an organization. Does anyone know who wrote that? Who did?
Thank Probably you one. Very much. Welcome.
That. But how many have that? I mean, how many struggle with that? I assume that, that's a common common thing. So we picked this because it is pretty useful and pretty common.
Do you want me to go first or do you want to?
Yeah, because I got to think about that.
Okay. I'll tell you, this is a definition. If you've been in any of my training classes, you will have heard me talk about this. The first is our belief, and we may have talked about this on a podcast before, is that we are out of the phase of the decision maker mentality anymore.
Yes.
And so those of you who have been around or you're a coach or talking about that, we're saying, well, are we talking to the decision maker? We believe that there's no such thing anymore, that everything is a combination of authority people and influence people that come together and the decision gets made some way, shape, or form. So we want to take away the idea of getting to a person and instead get into the process of their decision, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. So as you're thinking about that, and even as you talk in your offices together about things, or your boss comes to you and say, well, are you talking to the right person? To me, there is not the right person anymore. There are multiple people involved. So that's a mental shift that we encourage our clients to take hold of first and foremost when it comes to talking about gaining access. Go ahead.
How'd you know I was going to say something? Was it my long, deep breath?
Going, the whole time I was talking.
So yeah, the process, and I think a lot of times we assume that the CEO is the ultimate decision maker.
Right.
And I've got a case right now with a prospect that we're working with, and the CEO is an influencer and probably the person who's going to sign the agreement and check, but there are several people inside her organization that are extremely influential.
Yes.
And so when you ask the question, who's the decision maker, you're going to get lied to.
Correct.
And number two, when you don't ask the question and assume on your own, you're going to fail there. You're going to have a faulty assumption.
Yeah. Yeah, and the people you're going to miss are the people that are the high influence, low authority people that you'll pass by and say, well, they're going to be users of whatever I do, but they're not making the decision, and they will throw you under the bus, and you'll go, I don't know what happened.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, good point.
Very, very common. Right. So Dave Letterman, you
That's right.
Going to hit someone in the eye. We're going to get sued. It'll be our last live podcast ever.